Hello guys, welcome back to my channel Mission Critical. I hope you're doing absolutely fine. So today in this video tutorial, we will learn how to make a PCB, that is a printed circuit board. So we will convert our circuit idea into a PCB using an online software called as EasyEDA. So yeah, let's jump into this tutorial. This video is sponsored by ALLPCB.com. ALLPCB is an ultra-fast PCB superfactory based in China, which is known for its high-quality PCB at affordable costs. They offer services like PCB manufacturing of 1 to 14 layer boards. One new addition to its services is aluminum PCBs. Do check them out, link is in the description below. First step for any electronic project is idea. So for today's tutorial, let's make something simple, for which we will make a LED dimmer circuit based on IC555. So now that we have an idea, let's draw it out on a paper and understand what we are making, which in my case is a simple LED dimmer that generates PWM signal by using IC555's a stable mode. Let's not jump into details and start with the designing already. So jump into your computers and search for EasyEDA on browser, register on the site, and we are good to go. Make a new project and you will see the canvas in the middle of the screen, which will be used to make a schematic. On the right side we have tools and attributes. On the left side we have components. Now let's keep this EasyEDA project aside and let's build our circuit on a breadboard, since it would be a better idea to test the circuit before implementing it on a PCB. To do so, we will need to connect the components according to circuit diagram, which is pretty straightforward. After the connections are done, we can see our LED is fading in and fading out. So basically our dimmer circuit is working as expected. Once the testing is done and we are confident of the circuit diagram, we will import all the necessary components on the canvas and start connecting according to our circuit diagram. We can click on the library to choose the required components for our schematic. But the only problem here is to select the proper component, as every component has a different footprint or size. Since we already have our components in hand, we can easily measure the pad distance of each component and the overall size. So here for an example, I will add IC555. So we'll search for IC555 in the components column and double click on the results. On the right side we can see a footprint option. Open its footprint, change the unit from mil to mm, and use the dimension tool to measure the distance between the pad, and we will match it physically and repeat the process for all the components. Once the components are imported, we will use wire tool to complete the connection, and also we will use VCC and ground ports from the given tools. Once the schematics are done, save the project and convert it into a PCB by clicking here. You will see components with blue lines and a purple box, layers and object folder bar. The purple box is board outline in which outer shape of the PCB are arranged. The layer toolbar indicates the position of layer on which we are working. Firstly, drag and drop each component between the board layer and align them as needed. Here, we can either auto-route the entire PCB or manually connect each component. I would suggest to manually connect each component, for which go to the top layer by clicking on the pencil icon near the toolbar. Select the track tool and connect the components following the net, that is blue wires, and once the joint is successful, the blue lines will disappear. We will continue the connections for all the components in the similar manner. Thank you. And finally, export the file as a Gerber. But before we do that, let us perform a design rule check, that is a DRC check, and then save it in our computer. This DRC check will make sure that we do not have any error in design. After that is done, we will order this designed PCB using ALLPCB.com's PCB manufacturing service, which is very easy. Simply go to ALLPCB.com, enter the dimensions, select the quantity, number of layer, and then keep every other setting same as standard. We will select the solder mask layer to be white and upload our Gerber file to place the order. A week later, I received this package and then opened it. Looking closely under the magnifying glass, I examined the traces, tested the connections using a multimeter, and checked the silk layer. The overall quality of this PCB, given the price, was very astonishing. After I was satisfied with the proper PCB testing, I soldered the circuit and tested it. So finally we converted our idea of 555 timer and made it a working prototype using a PCB board. So guys, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something out of this video. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to Mission Critical for such awesome content. Goodbye.